This portion of WCW Saturday Night on the Superstation TBS is brought to you by Snickers. Hungry? Why wait?
Booker T and Stevie Ray, brothers, tag team champions, Harlem Heat. Truly the team of the 90s, winning the world tag team titles a total of 7 times over the past 5 years. But injuries and want for single success tore the two apart. An injury to Stevie Ray sidelined the big man for a few months. During that time, Booker T achieved championship glory, becoming a world television champion. Then, Booker T went down with an injury that put his TV title reign in peril until his big brother Stevie Ray stepped in. But his actions were obviously hollow and self-serving, causing even more friction between the two when Booker T returned. Then the separation grew as Stevie Ray joined the NWO and grew even more as he became the leader of the Black and White. But over the past few weeks, they have come to each other's aid.
Brother, I'm asking you for your hand. I need my brother to watch my back. Let's do it like we used to do it back in Harlem, baby.
And now, the two brothers are reunited once again. Harlem Heat. Two brothers fighting as one.
And yes, they are two brothers on a mission with a goal firmly set in their sights, and that's gaining the World Tag Team title for the 8th time. Booker T, Stevie Ray, the Harlem Heat have that chance 1 week from tonight at Road Wild 99 when they face the Triad. And Dusty, there are many people in World Championship Wrestling that feel that now that Ric Flair is no longer in power, that the Triad doesn't have the president on their side. And the Triad's tenure as World Tag Team Champions may be limited. It may be numbered. And Harlem Heat look like they're on the verge of making history next Saturday night.
You know, if we get ready to take a look and I get Harlem Heat back together against two young men that have really shown the fire to stay in the ballgame and try to be gamers. We'll talk about Tyree. We'll talk about what they have going for them as Dallas State. Two times he said, World Heavyweight Wrestling Champion, a player in the big game, a man that's been with the big boys, and a young man named Canyon who probably revolutionized the moves and things that are happening right now in our industry, and one of the most devastating big men of all in Bam Bam Bigelow. So if Harlem Heat being back together, they could be rusty. They could still have a disagreement. As you know, Stevie Ray, Booker T was doing tremendous as a single before an injury overcome him. Still, if they have that fire that they have, and remember this, Iron Mike, nothing is stronger than blood. Brother, family. So they have a shot at it, legitimate, but are they ready to face three guys, not two?
Well, you were talking about Diamond Dallas Page and certainly the role that DDP has played in the Triad. I'm thinking back to this past Thursday on Thunder when the Triad, as well as, of all people, David Flair, the reigning United States heavyweight champion. And boy, it's
That's
difficult to say that. It
joke.
Really is tough when you think of all the great superstars of our sport that put blood, sweat, and tears into gaining that United States heavyweight title when David Flair was handed that belt on a silver platter. But nonetheless, speaking of DDP, I have just been handed a note, and obviously you working very closely with the WCW Executive Committee, you are aware of this. This matchup has just been added to the Road Wild 99 pay-per-view 1 week from tonight, and it's going to be the third meeting between these two competitors, Diamond Dallas Page to face the Canadian crippler Chris Benoit. But an extra stipulation has been added. It's a no disqualification match.
Well, I want to tell you what, I'm aware of that. And they were trying to get the I's and T's crossed and everything to get that thing in as we watch Harlem Heat. And what I'm saying, Chris Benoit to me should be the United States heavyweight champion. The deal that went down with David Flair where he did not win the title, his daddy gave him the title. It's what really, you know, chaps me. And I'm going to tell you a little story here. Hey, this might be, you know, disorderly conduct ain't gonna just go out here and lay down. Oh, will Kevin Nash lay down again at this pay-per-view?
for Hollywood Hulk Hogan. I want to get that ending, and that was good the way I did that. Anyway,
great segue.
I know it's good. To finish up real quick about what I'm saying about these guys right here and the Ric Flair, closest with Dallas Page. If he's going to have to pay for his deeds that he's done in the past, I'm talking about the Nature Boy Ric Flair. Young guys are going to come to me, Lex Luger, Chicago, Illinois, 57 minutes into the match for the United States heavyweight title. A lot of blood, sweat, and tears were lost that night. That's what the U.S. title is all about, not giving it to my son just to make him go up the ladder. So I'm through with that. Going with it.
Off the elbow, Booker T goes for the cover on Mean Mike and gains a two count. Disorderly conduct, well, they are certainly no strangers to the world of tag team wrestling. Tag is into Tough Tom for the better part of the last decade. Disorderly conduct has been working as a tag team as well. You talked about ring rust. This past Monday on Nitro, the Harlem Heat in their first match back certainly didn't see any ring rust when they defeated the Triad in a non-title match. Cover now by Booker T. Hook of the leg and a two count from referee Mickey J. Harlem Heat, they get their shots at the belts. And the committee, they had to realize that a victory in a non-title match gained them the shot at the World Tag Team titles currently held by the Triad.
Let me go back to ring rust, what you said. I call it team rust. They had no ring rust because they were individually out there doing their thing. But team rust, back together, knowing what to do. Go back to the thing. Hey, blood is the deal. You know what I mean by that? It's very simple. Family's the deal. I don't think they ever lost it. I think this is going to be one of the premier. Wow! Look at this. Almost a form of clubbing. Not quite, because it was two fisted instead of four. I believe at this pay-per-view, we will see a tremendous battle for the World Tag Team title. And you know, the World Tag Team title, IMAC is back up there on that pedestal where it belongs. Great athletes competing each and every week.
No question about that. And can you believe this organization actually considered dropping tag team wrestling several months ago? And what we've seen over the course of the past few months is tag team wrestling gaining in stature to the point that those world tag team titles are among the most prized possessions of any of the championship belts here in WCW.
Well, I'm going to tell you what, well, this disorderly conduct, they understand the importance of getting a... Can you imagine a victory right here on the verge of this pay-per-view?
The cover on Booker T in a two count before he's able to kick out. Yeah, can you imagine disorderly conduct coming in here on WCW Saturday night and spoiling things?
Wow.
They're in the roles of the spoiler, and I'm not talking about Don Jardine.
No. Man, did you throw that up? I can't believe you said that. I cut my teeth on him. You know, I was his partner one time, 19 years old. The Spaller and me in Texas, Gary Hart with us. That's another story. That's a whole hour program. So Don Jardine and me. Man, I'm telling you, he was. You talk about big men, Don Leo Jonathan, Don Jardine, great big men. Had a claw to match only, maybe a little bit, of the legendary Fritz Von Erich.
And of course, I remember Don Jardine with that agility and walking the ring ropes as we see Booker T spring off the ropes. But disorderly conduct. This tag team is ready.
Look at him.
Just nailed him with a knee to the midsection and follows up the attack with those big overhand clubbing blows to the back of Booker T.
I want to tell you what, they got him in a little trouble here. Booker T is some trouble. You know, disorderly conduct needs, they're punishing this guy. They need to go ahead and try to cover him. There you go. But no hook of the leg. How many times have we said that? I was with a group of our young athletes down at the power plant just recently, and I was giving kind of a soliloquy, you know what I mean, and like a little seminar, and talking to them about rights and wrongs. Once you learn what to do, there are little things that will help you win, and one of them is cradling the guy, covering the guy, getting him up where he can't do anything. I mean, you know, and where you can get at least one, two. Here you go.
Certainly, as a quick attempt here by disorderly conduct, Mean Mike just takes Booker T back down to the mat. Certainly so many of those youngsters at the WCW power plant are lacking in just one thing, and that's the guidance that someone of your status, a great three-time world heavyweight champion, a veteran like the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, can bring to those youngsters that are inexperienced.
And here
disorderly
we go.
Conduct
here we go.
Off the toe. That move backfired.
Big, first mistake they've made, really. And a mistake like this can cost you. If he gets over and tag, that's what I'm talking about, team rust. He has yet been able to tag, which he might do right now. Stevie Ray to get it done.
Well, you make a great point about that, but Stevie Ray, the power man of the team, he enters into the battle. First, the double clothesline, a pair of rights and a pair of big boots, and disorderly conduct is in trouble. Quick tags.
That's
Booker
the way they,
T.
That's it. That's their key.
He's the legal man now in, and Booker T goes airborne. Caught him with the flying forearm, gets one, barely a two count before Tough Tom breaks up the tag. Now all four men in the battle. Referee Mickey J trying to control these athletes, but disorderly conduct and Harlem Heat, and it's breaking down on Saturday.
Oh.
Whoa, what a backdrop over
bad.
The top.
Yeah. Look at this.
Speaking of double team moves, Harlem sidekick with an assist from Stevie Ray, and Booker T scores the pin.
Oh, have mercy. Yes, sir.
Well, they may have showed a little team rust, but they were able to put it together and didn't show any ring rust. Booker T, Stevie Ray, they're focused on just one thing, the World Tag Belt.
Eight chance to be World Tag Team Champions coming up. They could get it done, and I'm going to tell you something. At this pay-per-view, at the bigness of it, it's going to be something to see this match.